What, according to you, is a smart city?
See, smart city is a very good initiative from Government of India. In fact, that is the way we are trying to look in creating better environment for citizens. Up till now, what we have seen is we all were paying, those who are employed, paying taxes. But those taxes were going on in, we are not knowing where they are going in. At least with this initiative, all citizens are happy, at least those who are working and paying for that taxes, that something will be done for them. So it would look like quality of life is the main theme. And under quality of life, you have public transport, you have better water facility, you have better power, you have better security, health. So many things are coming up to it. And as I also put up a question that Uday, one more scheme from Power, Ministry of Power, talk about that honest person should not pay for dishonest. Yeah. That means you're trying to increase the efficiency, control theft. Same way, it's this smart city coming in, you're looking at the health environment wherein you are paying and you're getting the services for that. So we talk about smart transportations, we talk about solar-based energy, clean energy coming in. So a good move, a good initiative, and certainly something which happens, it takes a little time to happen. So we all have to wait, watch, and participate in this to make it happen. We can't be just only at the complaining edge. Okay, the funds have been given by the government, what is happening? Till the time we don't control things at our end, nothing will get impacted. If we don't litter, city will be clean. But we have to make our cities, there's an awareness in Delhi that make your clean city clean. So in that case, if we are able to control ourselves in terms of littering, city will become clean. So everyone has to have his own place, and that place has to be understood. The change starts from oneself. So once you start to bring that change, certainly the city will become smarter and this initiative will be successful.
Tell us something about your company and how are you looking at this smart city project?
The company which I'm representing is the SAS, which is SAS. And they have been into data analytics for the last 40 years. And we have been in India for the last 20 years. We have been helping government agencies, especially if you look around the census board, to know about what population is doing. We also work around with the census, with the electoral data, in terms of how the people are behaving and things. In smart cities specifically, we are trying to play a role in water, how to make a water controllable so that we can control on the quality of water, the treatment of water, the way the losses which are there. So there are losses which are non-revenue water, we call it, how to basically government knows about it. We're also working on energy part, how you can have a better energy efficiency coming in, solar energy, wind energy, how they can be used, and then less of dependency on the thermal and can be made on gas can be made. So we're trying to make a step in the clean energy space. We are trying to work on transportation, where say how the data help us in knowing what is the congestion on which part, so that the transportation side, we can get to know how many vehicles have to be plowed on that particular route. We also get to know what are the service systems, maintenance aspect of the vehicle, so that the vehicles are running. Because they are like a machine, so machine require a serviceability. So based on data, you get to know how the services are happening, what point of time. You also know on which route you have higher number of passengers, you can ply more vehicles, so that at least you can have better monetization. And also you can try to bring in the aspect of making people use less of the private transport, more of public transport. So that data is helping. So transportation, water, energy, health part of it, very important to know about the uses of various plans for various diseases, outbreak which happens, right? How that can be controlled as a part of it. So based on the data, assessment, analysis of where the government schemes are coming in. If you're looking at sensor-based data, that's very important. Today, we're talking smart cities all about Internet of Things, IoT. IoT means there are sensors all around. The sensors could be on the road, sensors could be there in the street light, and these sensors are telling that, okay, what point of data coming in. So if there is a 911 vehicle, ambulance coming in, it will basically sense that this vehicle is coming in. It will try to pave way for people to make the ambulance move. So smart city is that kind of approach which you're looking at. And this is where the company is trying to work on and create an awareness in this entire area with the government and with the state utilities.
Deloitte India recently estimated a cost of $150 billion for the smart city project. How do you see private sector's role in this?
Certainly, if you look around for a common Indian, let me try to put the numbers into it. It's a billion dollar into the crores part of it for people to understand better. So it's about 100 crores per city per year is coming to all. So you can multiply by that into 5 years is 500 crores and then equal amount of investment coming for the government part. Now, we also know that this amount is very small, right? As a part of improvement. So the government is saying, let private investors come in. Now, we all know that when the private investors are coming in, right? Certainly there is a increase in the efficiency and the outcome of the entire program. Because private investors, when they try to invest, they'll make a services, make it happen quicker and better, and then try to monetize it part of it. And in this stream, you find a lot of builders, if you look around, the real estate part of it again, is going to be benefiting. Because everything is infrastructure based. Whether we're talking about the city system has to improve upon, retrofitting it, or we're talking about the new areas, it's about building. It's about creating assets. It's about putting in those mechanism over there. So now the builders who are there, who are trying to create those cities or the apartment complexes, have to look upon bringing in, apart from the utility industry power, solar energy, right? They can put on the rooftop, create that way that you have more space where you can put a panel on the wall. So builder gets a part of it. Now when they're trying to go with this part of activity, certainly other people are encouraged to invest more. Today, as you look into become lifestyle, we say that we are staying in, whether it's an LSL building, whether it's a Vistri Visteria or whether it's some other Mahagun kind of builders. Now, the whole idea is people associate themselves because the utility, the facility which are there, they are smart in nature because you pay for a single point of system for water, single point for your electricity, you don't have to go and stand in the bill part of it. So all this facility will help the real estate sector, the infrastructure sector to create more assets which are better in nature. And along the lines of where these cities have been identified, you know the 20 cities have been finalized in the first go. And these 20 cities including Allahabad, Varanasi, Vizag, and we have Jaipur, we have Udaipur. Now there is a lot of scope in this sector, the cities. A lot of scope in terms of, apart from the government initiative, private party to invest and let the habitants, as our former secretary of Ministry of Urban Department, morning, Mr. Krishnan was talking about, that the lifestyle will improve, and when the lifestyle improves, then people want to invest in that particular area, and that is where basically you are trying to bring public partnership to private partnership. So PPA models will emerge more, and then you will have investment coming in, and that everybody will reap benefit out of it.
How will your company's initiatives help people to become smarter?
Earlier the perspective of smartness was how you're looking from the outside, right? Now the perspective is changing from the way how in which environment you are there, right? So today we have smart gadget with us, right? The smart gadget tells us what is the temperature outside, what is the congestion outside, right? What time of schedules are there, so you are able to behave and work on that particular smart device, right? Now these devices are getting smarter, then in order to get the information on the device, you require analytics to work on that. So as I mentioned about that data is there coming out from all places, whether I'm talking about the IoT, which is sensors based data, these sensor data has to be analyzed quickly, so traffic part of it. Or surveillance system. Now in surveillance you have to analyze that where that particular safety or security aspect has to look in. We are also looking in on the part of like parking sensors or the video sensors which are there on different multi-level parking, or the data is mass. Now you can't really store all the data part of it. You have to look in which data is useful to you. And that is where the analytics will be evolving on doing the things, bringing much more benefit at the edge, where the things are happening. Now, when you're doing some kind of rules and alert putting in the beginning itself, you are trying to control there itself. Instead of the data comes to the control center and try to analyze them. So this is where the data helps you in terms of making much more meaningful and become more smarter with the apps which you are there. Not about the dress which you wear, it's more about the information which you carry and help in doing work. So I believe that's where the SaaS can contribute much more.